And now, Big Polly's World of Sports Sims presents the GSW Match of the Week. Today we have Jim Lundos defending his World Heavyweight crown against the very skilled Dory Funk Jr., the brother of Terry Funk, who Lundos successfully defended the title against last week. And we are in the Houston circuit, Paul Bosch country, in week number 7 of year number 4. And hello and greetings from what they are now calling Champa Bay, Florida. Some people are also calling it Tampa Bay, and a few others are calling it Title Town. I'm Big Polly coming to you, and tonight we have a very good match for you. We have Dory Funk Jr., the brother of Terry, the only two brothers to ever have won the NWA world title. He gets a crack at Jim Lundos, and we're hearing the strategy for Dory Funk Jr. is not to do a lot of rule-breaking tonight. He's going to play it a little closer to the vest. There are a bunch of fans at the Sam Houston Coliseum in Houston, Texas, who have come all the way down from Amarillo to see him compete. Of course, Amarillo was one of the hotbeds for the Funks in their real-life career. So with that, we're going to take a look real quick at some title changes that have occurred in GSW, and here is the roll call as it stands right this very minute. We have a brand new World Junior Heavyweight Champion, and no, that is not a typo, Jerry the King Lawler, who in real life was an NWA, he wasn't an NWA, but he was a Southern Junior Heavyweight Champion early in his career. So if you could do that, if you were a Regional Junior Heavyweight Champion, or a World Junior Heavyweight Champion, or what that became in later years. Of course, WCW had a World Cruiserweight title in the 90s. And if you have won the a junior heavyweight title, or if you had a wrestling weight, according to Google, of 225 pounds or less, you could qualify for being the junior heavyweight title. So it was Jerry Lawler in Memphis defeating Hiro Matsuda. So he is now the junior heavyweight champion. He is the first man in GSW history to win the heavyweight title and then drop down and win the junior heavyweight crown. So congrats to the king. We have brand new international tag champs. The Road Warriors trounced the Hell's Angels out of the Pacific Northwest in a match in Minneapolis this past week. So the Road Warriors add to their very impressive title resume. And with that, we will tell you about the matches that have already occurred in Houston this week. Crusher Verdoux and Paul Orndorff was the opening bout. Orndorff in his second match in GSW, but Verdoux crushed him with a faceplant slam at 11:33. So Orndorff is looking for greener pastures. We had a Battle of the Bullies, which I like to do sometimes, between Johnny Barrand and Boris Malenko. Malenko was a heavy underdog, but he held Barrand to a draw over 30 minutes, and this was a bloodbath between these two, and Barrand did most of the bleeding, although Malenko had a noticeable cut. So maybe we see these two again. Malenko and Barrand in the last card at Houston 4 weeks ago crossed paths with each other, and they might be on the same side, but they didn't really like each other all that much. In the third bout, Leroy McGurk and superstar Billy Graham, the former WWWF champion title holder, I should say. It was Graham winning at 17:30 with a disqualification. McGurk caught a little bad luck. He knocked Graham over the top rope. And here in GSW, you are subject to disqualification if you do that, and Graham did a little bit of acting and kind of convinced the referee to disqualify McGurk, and the fans were not happy. They were chanting an eight-letter word beginning with B and ending with T. I believe it had something to do with fertilizer. In the fourth bout, it was Bruiser Brody coming back to GSW after a long suspension. He beats Dick Hutton, Cowboy Dick Hutton, with illegal punches at 28-28, a four-star match between those two and the best match we have had so far on the card. Scott Casey and Wahoo McDaniel and the Asian Assassins of Ricky Chosu and Masa Saito went to a 30-minute draw. And in the match that just concluded before we hit the airwaves, a double countout between Danny Hodge and Terry Funk. Of course, Funk was the last opponent of Jim Lundos. Funk suffered an early cut that was nasty. And that got Funk all hot, and those two brawled, and Hodge was able to hold his own. Of course, he was also a former professional prize fighter in the heavyweight ranks in the 1950s, winning all of his fights, but I believe two. And that sets up our main event, which is Jim Lundos and Dory Funk Jr. And we are ready to go. There goes the bell. This is for the world title. Dory Funk has 60 minutes to score a pin or a submission to become the world champion. And Vogue thinks Lundos should be victorious here. Pause for a moment. And off we go. Pile driver attempt right away by Lundos. Might score a pin. It does not. And 51 seconds in, Dory is in a little bit of trouble. Last time we saw Dory Funk in the ring, Andre the Giant was his foe, and they went to a double countout. So far this year, Lundos is 4-0-1. His draw with Terry Funk in Detroit being his most recent verdict. A very odd in-ring double countout where they butted heads. And neither could get up before the count of 10. And a legal whip to the ropes by Lundos. So in the early going, Lundos has a clean sheet. And Funk has been the receiver of some holds. A suplex attempt countered by Funk. A headlock. And Dory has scored his first hold of the match at the 2:11 mark. A body slam by Dory Funk Jr. We'll look at the stamina levels real quick. Dory Funk 42 points away from losing 5 points of stamina across the board, or almost. Jim Lundos 70 points away from dropping 4 points. And a pin attempt on Lundos. No pin. It was a flying leg drop there by Funk. Legal speed move by Lundos, countered by Dory Funk Jr. Of course, Dory Funk Jr. was famous for holding the NWA title for 4 years. He won the title, oddly enough, in Tampa over Gene Kaniski in 1969, about this time of year, 52 years ago. Dory Funk, with a suplex attempt, has a 1 in 40 chance of getting that count of 3, but he does not. No action by Funk. A legal leg hold by Lundos. Lundos, of course, was one of the star grapplers of the 20s and 30s, the Great Depression era. And if you have read Hooker by Lou Fez, he kind of has or Fall Guys, great book on wrestling called Fall Guys about the wrestling in the early 20s and in the 20s and 30s. He does not have a great reputation with his contemporaries. Lou Fez pointed out that Ed Strangler Lewis, who was often Fez's manager, did not like Lundos at all. Legal leg hold by Lundos. Legal leg hold by Dory Funk Jr. Legal arm hold by the Funker. And a legal headbutt. So Funk putting a good little combination of moves together, and the damage is now 35 off for Dory Funk and now 52 off for Lundos. So could Dory Funk Jr. become the GSW World Champion tonight? A body slam? No. Lundos finds the ropes, but Lundos seems to be reeling a little bit. Leg lock. Very effective leg lock that Lundos could put on, but it was countered by Dory Funk Jr. We are now 8 minutes and 26 seconds into the bout. Legal neck hold by Dory Funk. Suplex attempt by Dory, and a beauty. It's a 10-point loss of stamina for Lundos, and Lundos now close to losing a stamina level. He's a little closer now after a legal neck hold. 9:12 into the bout. A body slam countered. Lundos was ready for that, but Lundos about a move away from dropping a stamina level. And Lundos with a rip to the ropes and a double thrust to the throat. 6 more points off of Dory Funk. So now he closes in on losing a stamina level. Outside the ring action, punches thrown by Dory Funk Jr. And the ref says, "Hey guys, get back in the ring, would you?" Legal chop by Funk, and Lundos has lost the stamina level first with that move. No, actually, it was countered. It was the punches outside of the ring that had Lundos drop a stamina level. I'm trying to stay accurate here. Londo series of punches to the head. Now Dory Funk Jr. is now closing in on a loss of stamina level. That's 5 points off. We're now at 86 off of Londo's, 46 off of Dory Funk. Body slam. Dory Funk also has a father, Dory Funk Sr., who was a staple in Amarillo, and he passed away in the early 70s. He was in national demand when Dory Funk won the NWA title. Junior won the NWA title. Body slam by Londos. And Amarillo was a big influencer on how others should run their circuits. Of course, Eddie Graham, who was the godfather of Florida wrestling in Tampa, was in the Funk's Amarillo circuit for a while. Pinholds by Dory Funk Jr. Specialty move, leg lock, no pin. Now Dory closing in on that stamina level loss. An eye gouge by Londos, so he could roughhouse with the best. No action. We are 12:10 into a 60-minute time limit. Legal whip to the ropes. And that is going to be a stamina level reduction for Dory Funk. So he finally hits that stamina level. He's 61 points away from his next stamina loss. And Londos is 84 points away. A legal arm hold by Londos. So both these men getting tired and getting more prone to being pinned. That's 5 points off of the stamina level. Submission move, we'll run it anyway. No, doesn't succeed. Both of these men not going to submit too often. Actioning outside the ring, and Londos catches Dory Funk Jr. as he tries to get back to the arena, off of the arena floor. Well, Funk tried to re-enter, and then that knocked him back to the arena floor. Both get back in the ring. The unconscious hold was countered, better known as the sleeper. Disqualified check by Funk, nearly gets disqualified, but it was not deemed a disqualifying act. Submission move. Spinning toe hold by Londos, a reduction of 5 points. Now the damage is about even, 86 off of Londos, and now Funk has fallen behind Londos with 94 off. Londos drives the knee into the back of Dory's leg, 7 points more gone. And Dory Funk Jr., his stamina level here is wilting away. Legal punches by Londos. So Londos putting together a nice little connection of moves here. Specialty move, the unconscious hold, but that's not going to be a submission. Legal leg hold countered by Londos. And now it is Dory Funk that's struggling to keep his stamina level up. Arm holds by Londos outside the ring. A suplex tried and countered by Dory Funk. So far in the match, we have had 5 pin attempts, 3 of them by Dory Funk Jr. Londos has hit finishers twice in the match, but they have not led the pins. A body slam by Dory Funk Jr., 9 points off of Londos, but now it's Dory Funk who is a few points away from dropping another stamina level, but he's keeping in control and he's slowing down the match a little bit. A headlock by Funk Jr., 17:41 gone by in the match. This should get a high star rating, I would think. Technical action. Kick by Londos, and now Dory Funk 2 points away from a stamina level hit. Londos, auto control loss. Londos was taking too long, and Dory Funk capitalized on it, and now he has control. Legal forearm, and you know Dory has that uppercut forearm that he likes to use, where he uses his forearm like an uppercut boxer, like the uppercut of a boxer would use. And it was a very neat and vivid move when Dory would do it. Dory has an auto control loss here, so back to Londos. Legal leg hold, and now Dory Funk loses another stamina level. His pin count now 40, 33. Submission move countered by Funk Jr. We'll just call him Jr. That's what everybody called him in the business, Jr. Armbreaker by Dory Funk, no submission. Legal choking by Funk Jr. 6 point loss of stamina for Londos. Right now we're at 124 off of Londos, 135 off of Funk. Hair pull by Dory Funk Jr. So Dory Jr. playing rough. Didn't I just say we were going to call him Jr.? Illegal choking by Jr. here. Loss of 6 points. So Dory snapping a little bit. Kind of like Honey Badger at the Super Bowl last night, snapping at Tom Brady. Didn't work out too well for him, did it? Lundos, an auto control loss. And again, Dory has control. Kick by Funk. 5 points off of Lundos. Strategy card used. Illegal forearm by Funk. So Dory Jr. now doing well again. Showing some signs of brilliance even against the mighty Jim Lundos. 7 points off for Funk Jr. To Lundos. It's now 146, 145. So Lundos again taking most of the damage. And this has gone back and forth through the match. We're now at the 23-24 mark. Barrage of punches on the Lundos, 15 points lost. And now Lundos could lose another stamina level. He's 9 points away from that. But a legal neck hold by Lundos slows things down, and Dory loses 6 more. It's now 161, 141. Funk ahead for you losing the least number of points. No action, and an auto control loss. Submission move on the Lundos. You're not going to get him with a submission. At least this early, a suplex, and Lundos hits the mat with a thud and loses 10 more points. Lundos has now lost the stamina level again, it appears. So both men have now lost stamina levels twice. Dory Funk Jr. right now the closest to losing the next one, 54 points away, whereas Lundos is at 79. Lundos is now 36-32-1, and the rolls are of 1 to 40. So if it's less than 36, it goes to a 2 count. If it's less than 40 again, it goes to the 3 count. And if you get it 1 out of 40 times, Dory Funk Jr. would be the new world champion. Body slam by Funk. Dory doing very well. Probably the best anybody has done against Jim Lundos in his second reign. He took the title away week number 2 from Jerry the King Lawler, who is now the junior heavyweight champion of the world. 9-point loss. Body slam by Funk. So it's now 194 off of Lundos, 144 off of Dory Jr. Control loss. Back to Jr. Legal leg hold. 6 points off. Coming up to the midway point of the match. 26-26. And if we go 60 without a result, it's a time limit draw. Dory Funk has control. Chair shot to the face. Ooh. Fans of Amarillo cannot be that have come down by bus to the Sam Houston Coliseum could not be happy with that. 15-point loss, and now Lundos is closer to the next stamina level loss. He's at 40/4, and Dory is at 54/5. Dory now well ahead on damage. Kick countered, and now Lundos has control. Legal punches countered. Dory gets control back. Legal neck hold by Dory Funk Jr. And a head scissors on the Lundos. So Dory just beating Lundos to the punch over and over. Junior with a souple attempt, and that's good for 10. I had to get souple in there. I'm in Tampa. Come on. Legal biting by Dory Funk Jr. Right below the eye. It did not produce a cut. That's a very nasty place to be biting somebody, even if your name is Mike Tyson. Body slam by Junior. No, he didn't get to the 3 count. Legal chop by Lundos. So Lundos finally able to put a move on Junior. Junior now with 6 pin attempts. Lundos only with 2. And we are almost at the midway mark if this match goes 60. And we have a submission try on Dory Funk Junior. No submission. Lundos using arm holds, and now we have crossed the halfway point. 30 and a half minutes gone by, 29 and a half to go, or 29:24 to go. Arm hold. Lundos with a legal leg hold. He's got to try to put some moves together here. He's 12 points away from another stamina level hit. A legal chop by Lundos. No pin. Jim Lundos has control. And he's choking Lundos down. And Lundos about to lose another stamina level. He is 2 points away. That's another 10-point hit. And there it is. He's now lost 5 more points, and that kicks him down another stamina level. He's now 40, 36, and 1. We have 28 minutes left, and now the question is, can Lundos get out of town still holding the belt? Lundos has taken an incredible amount of punishment in this match. Spinning toehold, that was the move that won him the NWA title against Gene Kineski in Tampa at the Gasparilla card, which was usually the big card of the year in the late 60s and early 70s in Tampa. Was held around the time of the Gasparilla Parade that they would hold about this time of year in Tampa. Outside the ring action, punches thrown by Dory Funk. So Dory comfortably ahead on damage by 100 points. Sunset flip. No, you're not going to get him. Suplex attempt. No, didn't get him. Although Lundos had a much longer chance of being pinned there. The third count was a 35. If it was 12 or less, he would have been champ. Funk Jr. would have been champ. Dory Funk using a strategy card to prevent a DQ. Legal leg hold as I try to ward off the hiccups here. And Lundos makes Funk lose 7 points. Dory is closing in on another stamina level hit. He's already at 40-33. 40-30-3. Lundos, side headlock takedown with the legal throw, another 6 points lost. But Dory Funk, if there were a referee's decision, if this was a tournament bout, Funk would be comfortably ahead at this point. Suplex attempt by Lundos, but it was countered by Dory Funk. Pinhold try. Pinhold try. One has to come up. It does not. No pin. They tried a rolling reverse, but Lundos kicking out on two. Legal turnbuckle by Funk, but it was countered by Lundos. Action happening outside the ring. And now Funk has a cut. And he has lost the stamina level. Chair shot to the head by Lundos. And now Funk Jr. busted open. And now we have a very interesting match. Lundos gaining a little bit of momentum. Claw-like hold by Funk Jr. I didn't know he had the tendon strength in his hands to do that. Submission. Illegal leg hold by Funk Jr. Now it's a race against time. Single leg Boston, no. Boston Crab, suplex attempt, and a nice one, thud. Hits Lundos, and that's 10 points off of his stamina. You're just tuning in. We have yet to have a verdict between these two, and the match has gone 38 minutes and 40 seconds. Illegal punches by Funk Jr., a loss of stamina by 5, actually damage by 5, also a loss of stamina. Funk Jr. now a pin rating of 40, 40, and 3, but Lundos is closer to taking another stamina hit. Move countered by Lundos. Lundos with a legal speed move with a drop kick, and that is 6 points off of Funk on the damage side and the stamina side. Legal chop by Lundos. No action, back to Funk, but a submission move by Lundos. As we cross the 40-minute mark, 40 minutes gone by, 20 minutes left. And it's no action here between the two. Outside the ring action, chair shot again by Dory Funk. So both of these guys taking a seat the hard way to the head. And Lundos has lost 15 more points. He's closing in on another stamina. A low blow by Dory Funk Jr. Almost got pinned there. Third count came up a 2. If it were a 1, we would have had a brand new world champion. So Lundos struggling here in Houston. And Lundos on the verge of passing out and could barely stand. He has lost another stamina level. He's at 40, 40, and 5. So if that move had occurred a few moments later than it did, we'd have a brand new champion. We're at 41-55. Could we see an upset here? Legal punches by Dory Funk Jr. If Dory wins, we use his champions card, which has never happened in GSW before, and I will explain that should it happen. legal arm hold by Jim Lundos. There is a champion set card, which is given to the NWA, longtime NWA, AWA, WWF champs of the 60s through the 80s, and the card, the champion's card, makes the champion a much more dangerous opponent. Legal arm hold by Lundos, a legal leg hold by Lundos, Lundos with control. He's kicking and stomping at Dory Funk Jr. as Jr. is outside the ring. And Lundos is saying, like they say in the Monty Python movies, none shall pass. But he gets back in. Legal neck hold by Lundos. We're at 44 minutes almost. Legal throw by Lundos, 6 points off. Dory Funk with a slight laceration. He's at 269 damage with an 18 cut. And 348 off of Lundos. Disqualified check, possible DQ stop, suplex, and that nearly got Dory Funk. He got to the ropes, broke the count, pinhold, a kick by Lundos, suplex attempt by Lundos. So Lundos finding another gear here. Dory Funk lost another stamina level. Dory Funk Jr., he's now at 40, 40, and 13. So Dory Funk Jr. nearly out. And he's closer to taking another stamina hit. A legal elbow by Funk Jr., 6 point loss. So both these guys racing against the clock and racing against each other. A small package. Oh, Lundos just finding the ropes in time. We're 47-54 into the match. Legal arm hold by Funk Jr. Suplex attempt countered by Lundos. Illegal choking by Lundos. He's desperate to try to keep his title right now. He doesn't want to get himself disqualified automatically, which would automatically give him the title, but would also give Dory another title shot down the road, possibly at the GSW All-Star card on Week 8, which I believe is emanating from Phoenix. Lundos frustrated, which allows Funk Jr. to take a legal throat chop by Funk Jr., a five-point hit. I tell you, Dory Funk Jr. giving his all in this match, a five-point loss for Lundos for a legal arm hold. We're closing in on 10 minutes to go. We're under 10 now. Legal arm hold by Jr., 5 points off for Lundos. Funk Jr. closer to taking spinning toe hold. Oh, so close for Funk Jr. The spinning toe hold and Lundos finding the ropes. My goodness. He's going for it again. And he's got it this time. He's got it. And Dory Funk Jr. is the brand new world champion at 51-14. So I guess being in Tampa, 52 years after he won the NWA title at 69, history has more or less repeated itself. That's been happening a lot here in the Tampa Bay area, but nevertheless, we have a brand new world champion, and it's Dory Funk Jr., who has done it. Jim Lundos will go back to New York. He might get a rematch in the coming weeks, but the reporter saying, "I am at a loss for words," Dory Funk Jr. has pulled off the almost unthinkable by defeating Jim Lundos for the World Heavyweight title. He got off to a good start, and he held his own against Lundos all night long. And we have a brand new champion, 51-14. The match will get a 5-star rating, and we have our 7th World Heavyweight champion, Lundos' reign, going 5 weeks, and now Dory Funk Jr. will get to use his champion card, and we will go through that next week in his title defenses. So congratulations to Dory Jr. on pulling it off tonight. What a card. What a match. He had Lundos reeling about midway through the match on, and we have a brand new GSW World Heavyweight Champion. So I hope you enjoyed these last half an hour or so. Our match went about 30 minutes in real time. And we hope you all enjoyed it. And now Dory Funk Jr. will take his title on the road. He'll have a title defense next week. I do not remember where offhand. Maybe I should call it up and see what his schedule will look like. You will have two title defenses next week. One will be on the GSW All-Star card, and another will be, yeah, he will be in Tokyo defending his championship against scheduled to be against Hiroyoshi Tenzan, but that may change. I'm sure Antonio Inoki will want a shot at him, and we'll see what the commissioner's office at the GSW complex in Tampa will say about all of that. Commissioner Soli will probably have something to say about all of that. It could be Inoki getting his shot against Dory Funk Jr. And the GSW All-Star card will be in Toronto next week. So we may have two matches to show you next week, one in Tokyo and one in Toronto in the International Combine Week. As we progress through that, we like to show you all the world title defenses here on GSW. So this has been Big Paulie coming to you. I didn't expect this, but a lot of things have been happening lately in the world of sports that have gone unexpected, like the Buccaneers winning the Super Bowl when everybody said it was going to be a close game. But we'll talk about that at some point down the road and in the future. We hope you enjoyed tonight's match. It was a good one. We have a brand new world champ. Take care, everybody. Godspeed and God bless, and we'll do it all again soon. Bye-bye for now, everybody.